This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're solving some basic proportions, and we do these three problems on this video. All right, you should have watched the video on what a proportion is, and in that video, we found out that if A over B equals C over D, then A times D equals B times C. So if you have just a simple fraction on each side of an equal sign, you can multiply the extremes, the A times D, and that should equal the product of the means, which is B times C. So let's do that for this problem. Solve for X. Try it on your own first. Okay, so what does it say? I could say 4 times 15 equals 6 times x, but it doesn't matter if I write 4 times 15. I don't have to write it exactly like this. I could write a times d and say, oh, that's a, that's d, equals b times c. Oh, what's that? X times 6. That looks funny to a lot of people, but that is absolutely okay to do that. That gives you 60 equals, and how do you write x times 6 usually? You usually write 6x. And then we could divide both sides by 6. And that will give us, well, 60 divided by 6 is 10. And 6 is cancel here. And it looks funny to write 10 equals x. We usually write that as x equals 10. Okay, so there's one way of doing it. Now here's how I do it. I find the variable, okay, and that's where I'm going to start with. So I look at what is diagonal from that, multiply it together. So I have x times 6. So x times 6, I'm going to write that as 6 times x. And then I look at the other diagonal, so just keep in mind what I'm doing. I'm multiplying those two numbers together, right? And then I'm going to multiply the other two numbers together right here, the 4 times 15. So you could do the 4 times 15 in your head, or you could write 4 times 15. I still get 6x equals 60. Divide both sides by 6, still getting x equals 10. All right, so basically I'm using this sentence in the box here to take fractions, right, and then go ahead and change it to an equation without a fraction. Now you might have noticed that 6/15 reduced. You could have actually done that first if you wanted. So, these are options. You could say, that reduces. So I'm going to first write that as what? Now, what is 6/15 reduced to? Well, I could divide the top and bottom by 3, right? So that would give me 2/5. Everybody okay with that? All right, and I could still use proportions. I could say, well, I'm going to look for the x. X times the 2, so 2x equals 4 times the 5, which is 20. Still dividing by 2 and getting x equals 10. That's an option if you want to reduce and then you have smaller numbers to multiply together. It's not much of a difference here. It's not like you really save much time. All right, let's go on to the next problem. All right, we have 15/35. Equals x over 14. So it's in proportion form, just a single fraction equaling another single fraction. So go ahead and put the video on pause and try this on your own first. Okay, so now let's do it. All right, so the way I like to do it is I find where the variable is, and it's right here. So I see what's across from that, and that's what gets multiplied with together with that, right? So I have 35 times x, or 35x, equals 15 times 14. Now, I don't know what that is, so I'm just going to leave it as 15 times 14. But if I want to solve for x, my next step would be to divide by 35. So the left-hand side is going to be easy. I'll just have x equals, and I just have to simplify this fraction on the right. Well, you could multiply 15 times 14, do long division, use your calculator or whatever. I'm going to do this by canceling. So I know that like 5 goes into the 15 and 35. So I'm going to divide 15 by 5 is 3, and 35 times 5 is 7. And let's see. Then I can also do the 14 over 7, right? And that will give me a 2 and a 1. So I have a 1 in the numerator. So I've got 6. X equals 6 without a calculator, without doing any multiplication or long division. I got X equals 6. Now, the other way, of course, is you could have multiplied out 15 times 14. And that equals 210. So I'm not going to show you the multiplication, but you can do that on scratch paper. And then I could divide both sides by 35. And you can go ahead and do long division if you like. Or you could try reducing this by dividing the top and bottom by 5, and then dividing the top and bottom by 7, etc. You will still end up with x equals 6. Okay, 210 divided by 35 is still going to be 6. Now, another thing you might have noticed is this first fraction, 15 35ths, wasn't even reduced. So before even doing your cross multiplication, remember you do the product of the means equals the product of the extremes, you could have just reduced that fraction. So how would you reduce 15 35ths? This is just an option. Dividing the top and bottom by 5, that gives me 3 sevenths. So this here could have been modified before you even did anything else to write this as 3 sevenths equals x over 14. Now, some people could figure out x in their head because they think, hey, check it out. I'm going from a denominator of 7 to 14. I'm multiplying the denominator by 2 to get 14, so I'd multiply the numerator by 2. X is going to have to be 6. So there's a way you might figure it out without using proportions. Or you could use the proportions here. 7 times x equals 3 times 14. Divide both sides by 7. And once again, you could do 3 times 14 and get 42, and then 42 divided by 7, 6. Or you could have reduced the 7 and 14 and get x equals 6. Lots of different ways. And in fact, that's what's so cool about algebra and math. There is not just one way to do any problem. Well, maybe there's one problem. You know, there are some problems. There's basically one way to do it. But in proportions, as you can see, I could have several students doing this just a little bit differently. And no matter how they do it, they keep coming up with x equals 6. All right, here's another problem. Solve for x and write answer as a reduced fraction. Okay, this is a hint, is that I think you're going to have a fraction at the end. So we have 5 sevenths equals 3 over x. So why don't you try this on your own first? Okay, so what am I going to do? I'm going to find, by the way, notice that nothing reduces like in the last problem. This 5 sevenths can't be reduced. So I'm going to find my variable x, and that's going to be multiplied by its diagonal number, right? So we have 5 times x equals, and then we're going to multiply the other two numbers together, the 7 and the 3, 7 times 3. So 5x equals 21, and then we'll just divide both sides by 5. So this time, nothing reduces. So I have x equals 21 fifths. Now, that's written as a reduced fraction. If I were going to write it as a mixed number, we would do 5 into 21, which is 4 and 1/5. So what if I change my directions here? Solve for x and write answer as a reduced fraction and as a decimal. So reduced fraction, you can usually people just think of that as 21 over 5, but you know, this is reduced, the 4 and 1/5, right? It's just written as a mixed number. So how would I write this as a decimal? Well, I would just use a calculator or do 21 divided by 5. And if I did that, so I know I'm going to get the 4, right? 0.2. Because 1/5 is 0.2. So these are all really different ways of writing the answer. 21/5, 4 1/5, or 4.2. Originally, I just said write it as a reduced fraction, and so 21/5 would have been a perfectly good answer. So we'll do some more problems where we might have to round. We might have some problems with decimals. You might have some problems where we have some fractions in the numerator, so something like 1/2 over 3/4, etc. So to see more complicated examples, you want to keep watching this set of videos. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.